Welcome to NAMM 2009. My name is Greg Wallace. I'm with DJNN. We're here to play with the toys, check out all the new equipment, visit with some of the people that put this all together. We've got some big names here like Newmark, American DJ, Pioneer, among many others. So what we're going to do is go inside, play with the gear, talk to some people, find out what's new and what's hot, and find out what the DJs are going to be looking for in the next year to come. So, hey, let's go. Silvio, he's been with Denon for like 30, 35 years, something like that.
Yeah.
And there's a couple of new pieces that Denon has, and we're going to talk about those right now. Silvio, go ahead and tell me about this first piece right here.
Sure. Thanks for joining us today. The first piece we're going to talk about is a DNS 3700. Very, very exciting new piece for us. It's a brand new tabletop. And some of the things that I'd like to tell you about that makes it very unique is the first and foremost is the platter. The platter size is now 9 inches versus 7 inches that we've been doing for the last 5 years in various other products. So it gives you a larger work surface for control. Also, the platter itself has a torque adjustment, 3 levels of torque that you can adjust in the preset mode. It comes with a real piece of vinyl that just mounts right on top of there. And the feel is exactly like working the genuine analog turntable. That's one. Then the onboard effects. We do have 7 onboard effects. Echo, echo loop, flanger, filter. Filter has high, mid, low adjustment. Break, dump, and reverse. Over on this side is pitch bend, pitch range. The range that we have is 6, 10, 16, and 100. Key adjust. A long 100 millimeter slider. Up in this section here is looping, and that's traditional looping to create an A-B loop with the option to trim your A or B point just in case your loop didn't come out as intended. And here is your mode keys. You have CD, USB, and MIDI. So it does play CDs, it plays MP3 discs as well. It also hosts USB devices, which is really cool. So you can hook up an iPod, a thumb drive, a hard drive, up to 50,000 songs, and run it right through the machine, and it streams. And you can just use all this functionality right from a little thumb drive, which is really, really cool.
And can you change on the fly as you're going from media to media?
Yeah, absolutely. So you can just switch from CD to USB or vice versa. The fact that we create a database for any device that you attach to it makes it very quick to load up and become ready for you with regards to external USB devices.
And this is a really heavy-duty piece. I mean, this isn't just something for the casual DJ. This is for your really serious guy who wants to get out there and do some serious battling. And from what I understand, the price on this unit is pretty... it's a really great price compared to some of the other gear that you might see out there.
Absolutely. It's a very aggressive price. The unit itself weighs about 15 pounds, so it's built like a tank. And what we wanted to do with this piece is really focus on the past, the present, and the future. So regardless of where you're at as far as media, we bring that all together in this one beautiful piece. So if you're just playing CDs, we got you covered. If you want to expand out and maybe consolidate your CDs to a hard drive, lighten your load, we got you covered. And the MIDI functionality of this is also available for those who want to use this as a control interface with various DJ software, for example, like Traktor. All the keys, buttons, and switches is mappable over MIDI with the addition of a built-in sound card. So the sound card allows you to use this device and MIDI at the same time, so you don't have to go out and buy an additional sound card.
Okay, well, let's go ahead and move on to the next piece over here, which is a new mixer that Denon is offering. It looks like it's a tabletop mixer, the DNX1100.
Yeah, this is really what we're calling the companion piece for the DNS3700. And it's a workhorse analog mixer, four-channel. It does have a three-band EQ with full kills, trim, PFL meters that you can adjust your channels. And this is really cool, which has been used in many of Denon's models, is the matrixing, so you can route any source to any channel, which allows you to move stuff around freely. The channels here are 60 millimeter faders, and we also offer a very high quality crossfader that we call a flex fader. And the flex fader is tension adjustable, so you would pull the plate off and adjust the tension on it to your liking. Over in this area, this is a contour adjust for the crossfader, which is very common. What's uncommon is a contour for the channel faders. This is very odd to see on a mixer, but you can adjust the contour, and this is really great if you want to do a very nice, long, smooth mix, or you want to come in nice and early. This section here allows you to hook up an external effects processor or box. And it gives you plenty of options, so you can assign where you want the effects to route to, which any individual channel. It is pre or post, that's new on here, dry wet, and on off. Right above this is a booth output, which is balanced on the back. It's assignable as well, all the way up to all four channels in master with a level control. Everything has queuing, so you can hear the effects, the master, and individual channels through the queue. You can assign each channel to the crossfader just by assigning the switches here above. Microphones, two microphones, very important for the most mobile DJs.
Every mixer should have at least two microphones. For all you guys out there, mixers have to have two mics.
Absolutely, I agree. So the microphones, it's very uncommon to find a high, mid, and low for mic. Usually you find just a high and low. So this allows you to really tweak your sound in case you're getting some really nasty feedback. In addition to that, we have a ducking feature, which brings the volume down as you talk. Like you found the mixers about 20 years ago, and the ducking has a sensitivity adjust on the back, so you can control the attack time, how fast it comes back.
I like that, ducking and attack time. Boy, they came up with some really cool technical names for this. That's a very cool feature.
Yeah, that happens with a few beers.
Yeah, ducking. Well, you know what I like about this mixer is it's got bells and whistles on it. I mean, it's a really nice mixer, but at the same time, it's also a simple mixer. I mean, you don't have to be a rocket scientist. Some of these new mixers that are coming out, I'm looking at it saying, oh my God, I can't fly this. It's just too much. But this is a really nice unit. And I also like the idea of the adjustable fader going back and forth. I'm kind of old school. I like a little stiffer fader. So when I make my sweeps, when I'm doing my mixing, I like nice, slow mixes. I'm not really what I call a cut DJ, where I'm doing a lot of scratching and mixing. So with this piece, you can actually appeal to both styles of DJing.
Absolutely, without a doubt. So it does appeal for both styles of DJ. On the back side, you do have balanced outputs. I'll flip it around for you. Here, balanced output, and here's all your channel inputs. You do have 8 line inputs, 3 phono. Here's your send and return, which is balanced. Booth output, which is also balanced, very important. Your mic area here is a Nortrix combo and a 1/4 inch for the second mic, and these are both balanced, which is really handy. And your fader starts for each channel, which allows you to trigger a player like a 3700 just from the channel fader.
And you know what I like about your second mic? I see a lot of mixers, well, they'll have a first mic, and they'll put some adjustments for the first mic, you know, your highs and lows. And then on the second mic, it's like they thought maybe we should put one on at the last minute, and they just put it on a switch. But there's no control over it. So this way you can actually do bass, treble, and have control over both microphones. And you have three. You've got mid, lows, and highs, not just two, on both mics.
Yeah, absolutely. So we knew that was important for our customers, and we implemented that as well.
And I think you're hitting a market that is definitely something that's going to be interested in pieces like this. You know, there's a lot of companies out there that hit the low end, and there's a couple of companies that hit the really high end, but there's like a big gap in between, and where you need to have good equipment at a good price, and I think Denon is definitely addressing it.